everyone. Welcome to the Maryland Access Point Virtual Caregivers Conference 2021. We titled this conference Pumpkin Spice and Everything You because we all know that if you just have pumpkin, it's just pumpkin. Well, without a little spice, it doesn't have its flavor really, right? So caregivers are like the spice in someone's life. And we want you to know that we care about you, that we recognize that you are the spice in someone's life. So we want to tell you all about MAP. That's the Maryland Access Point. And what that is the point of entry for aging adults and adults who are 18 and over with disabilities. So when you call our number at 410-758-1040, you're calling the MAP line. And from there, we'll listen to some of your questions, some of your concerns, and we are there to give information and refer you to assistance. All right, well, I hope that you are ready for our conference this year because it's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to have information from our Sheriff's Department on fraud. That's huge, as you all know. You're getting the phone calls, you're getting the mail. So we're gonna hear from our Sheriff's Department.
Hi, I'm Sheriff Gary Hofmann, and this is a very important message that I need you to share with family or friends. If you have family that is not on social media, please play this video for them or send it to them in an email. Every day in our county, every day across our state, people are calling us to let us know that they have been scammed out of money. These callers that are doing these scams, they're very convincing. They prey on our seniors and they prey on vulnerable families throughout our county. If somebody calls you to switch energy or knocks on your door, please don't sign something until you've done your research to determine if they have been approved by the Better Business Bureau or other sources out there. A lot of times these are high pressure scams. The person will get you on the phone and they'll be talking to you and just asking you to let them go ahead and switch you. You'll save money. Some of these scams also want you to take and go to a store and purchase prepaid gift cards or green dot cards or some other form of payment. Nobody out there is going to do this unless it's a scammer. I'm asking you, please don't be a victim to this scam. This weekend alone, we had people send up to $2,500 of their hard-earned money in gift cards to somebody. These scammers are really good. They're gonna ask you to take a picture of the front of the card, take a picture of the back of the card, and send it to them. The second you do, the money's gone. We can't even get it, we can't find it, we have no idea where it is. It's been routed through so many sources. So please think wisely when you make those decisions involving your finances. Please hang up on telemarketers that you don't want to do business with. Ask them not to call, ignore the call, let it go to your answering machine. If by chance someone knocks on your door, turn them away. Other than that, please do your research. Make sure that you check with family and friends before you send any money to anyone via a prepaid gift card. It's your money. You can do what you want with it, but we don't want you to be a victim of a scam. Again, if you have any questions or concerns, you're urged to contact local law enforcement, or you can always give us a call at the Sheriff's Office at 410-758-0770. We're here as your community partners. We don't want you to lose your hard-earned money.
We're going to hear from the Maryland Extension Office on how to make a healthy meal. So that's exciting.
Cheryl, tell me about what we're going to do today in Southersville.
Hey, thank you so much, Fred.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah, welcome to all of the Shore Safe senior caregivers as well.
Great.
And we're here to show a little bit today about some swaps. I was thinking about that in 2021. Did you think it was a year of swaps?
Cheryl, we talked before we did this. I'm an old man now. 2020 and 2021 just flipped everything upside down. I don't care what it was, schools, our lives. So we need some good news from you today. Right.
And not only just the good news, but to think about how you can take information and make some healthy swaps. So
that's what we need to show today. Good. So tell me what we've got here, and I'll just do whatever you tell me to do.
Great. Well, I am a registered dietitian, and I work for the University of Maryland Extension. Mm-hmm. And in that, we show recipes, we give virtual programs, and with this swap idea, we've also swapped to back to the in-person programs that we had been doing. Right, so now I'm having a lot of fun. I'm going down to Graysonville, to Kent Island, teaching fresh conversations.
Teaching good stuff.
It's been fun.
And you're helping people live healthier and better, right?
Right.
Good. That's what it's all about.
With our swaps, also we got busy. My colleague is Beverly Jackie, and she is the tenure track professional over at Cecil County, Queen Anne's, and Kent County. And she and I worked on a swap. Publication, so making
recipe swaps.
Common substitutions for your recipe, making the recipes healthier. Okay, and we'll give you that website so that you can link to the publication, and we'll do that again at
the
end.
So we're going to swap some things and make the meal a better meal, right? Good.
Right. So besides that, we have also been creating a lot of tasty different recipes.
Yes, and so my stomach's already growling. We're in the program 2 minutes and I'm growling.
All right. Well, what I wanted to try to do today was think about, because it is not only a fast food day today, we also want to think about those that cannot go out and get any fast food or dine out. So we wanted to make a simple recipe
here at home.
Some
stuff you can do at home, which is simple.
Great. And it's 4 ingredients, and it is taking up all the three of the food groups. So it really, we hope that you'll like this recipe too, and you get to taste it.
I know I'm going to like it. Okay. It looks delicious. We haven't done anything yet.
Okay, great. So the recipe is a healthier potato puff casserole dish. Okay. And first, what we want to do is think of those clean and separate and cook and chill. Some of those 4 safety standards.
Now, so I see. Do this one more time.
Clean, because you have already washed your hands and have the gloves on. And I have already washed my hands and I'll be putting my gloves on. Okay, that's important to have the surfaces
clean. Have clean hands, get all that bacteria off, and where we're actually cooking.
Right, exactly. All those surfaces. So that's first. And then we talk about separate. So first, what we would like to do is have you cut some green beans.
Okay, get my green beans.
Right. What I want to do is cut those in half.
I just dump them right here?
You could do that. And this is a 12-ounce bag of fresh green beans. Okay. In this recipe, if you want to opt for a green bean that's a French cut green bean, you can also drain those and use that instead.
Okay, and actually chop those
up. Yep, you're going to chop those just in half. So just in half to make them a little smaller size. For eating.
By the way, you know my wife is taking notes in this, so I know what I'm doing at home when I get home tonight.
Okay. She'll be putting you to
chop
work.
Chop them, put them right in here?
Yep.
Okay, cut that one.
Yeah, they can just get chopped up and then go right in there.
That's easy to do, so I'm taking the green beans, I'm chopping them.
Any small pieces, they can just go in. Yeah, just trying to get it so that it's a little bit, you know, better for your casserole.
Just cut these in half.
Mm-hmm.
All of them?
Yep.
Okay.
Yep. And that is half the bag of a 12-ounce bag. Of fresh green beans. Mm. And if you're using the canned green beans, that is just a 15-ounce French cut green bean.
This is something easy to get at your market or wherever you shop.
And the best part is if you look for lower sodium products, that's gonna help this bring the sodium down in this recipe.
And these are things people have to be aware of, right?
Right.
The sodium and the salt and the sugar
content. Read the
label. It's there, by law it's there, right?
It's there and it's great information. You're doing a great job.
I'll tell you what, I'm a man of many skills, none of which is marketable, unfortunately. Okay. All right, we're almost there. So I've cut the green beans.
Uh-huh.
And just about got it.
Okay. And I'm going to take those green beans and put them onto the stove so that they can just boil slightly. You just want to get those steaming and boiling maybe about 4 minutes, 5 minutes.
The French gourmet had better watch out.
Okay. You did a great job.
This is a Scotch-Irish gourmet. Okay. Is there such a thing? Okay.
So I'm going to take that and go over and put that onto the burner that I have on. And get that heating. And I've taken the liberty, Fred, to just take and brown these hash browns a little bit in the oven.
Smell delicious and look great.
You want that to happen so that these get slightly browned, so that when you place them on the casserole dish, they'll, you know, cook a little faster.
Nice
this
texture,
is only
nice
about
brown,
20
nice,
minutes.
Nice
yeah.
brown.
So I'm going to take that out and set that aside. So we'll just go ahead and take our lid for our pot and put that on so it moves that along. Another way that you can steam is to just buy something like this, a little silicone steamer.
Yes, yes.
And you can put water in the bottom and then put that right into the microwave.
Very light, very,
very
flexible,
light,
easy to use.
Easy to clean.
Easy to use.
So just another way to do the steaming.
Okay.
Okay. We've taken care of our beans and we've taken care of our little tasty taters. Great. So this one is so easy because all we're really going to do next is take either a chicken, natural chicken breast,
right
that is
out of the
again
can here.
Right out of the can, that's low sodium, so it is already fully cooked.
Okay.
Or you can take a tuna, again, as low sodium as possible, and you'll take two cans of tuna if you use that. Yeah. But I decided to go with the chicken today. So in draining, you're getting off a little bit more juice from that chicken. All right. And by separate, we do mean that we don't want to use this cutting board, right, at all,
safe
because you've
clean.
Already, you know, the vegetables,
the green beans, right.
But we can really just take this and put this into our bowl that we're going to stir and mix everything in. So I'll do that. And if you want to take and just break
stir,
it up
break
slightly,
it up a little bit.
Just
okay.
a little bit.
It's my specialty, breaking up.
Okay.
Breaking up so very hard to do. You didn't know I sang, did you?
Yeah, sure. Okay. It's a nice one.
I promise I won't do it anymore.
We'll pull this out.
And you're very that big, nice. I can see you're separating items. We don't cut and then use it
you
again.
Don't have to do it, and that's plenty. Just a little bit to break it up.
Is that good?
That's great.
Okay.
All right. I wanted to show another option. Sure. If you didn't want to use the frozen puffs, the tater puffs, you can also take and mandolin your potato.
Okay.
If you've ever seen anything like this,
look at this.
Very inexpensive
this
tool.
This is a mandolin?
This is called a mandolin. Very inexpensive tool. You can get a lot of places. It's a very sharp blade.
Okay.
And then
gotta
you can
careful.
Adjust the blade so that it's thicker or thinner.
Okay.
So with that, I'm going to have you try this too here. You just want to take
just slide it across.
Across. Okay. And I'll show you what that looks like on the finished product so that you could see. See
and
if you
like
that.
That's called a mandolin.
It's called a mandolin. And see these nice thin slices it makes?
Now, if you're left-handed, can you switch hands?
Sure can.
Okay. Is that
and
right?
Then, right. And when you get near the end for a safeguard, you use this on the end of that potato in case you go. But you don't have to do the whole potato.
Like,
is that fun?
Oh, look at this.
Isn't that nice?
Heck with TV. I'm going to go fast order cook.
There you go.
And the mandolin is so easy to use.
It is.
I mean,
it is.
Believe me, if I can use it, anybody
can
use
it. And anyone can do that. And it's a vegetables, you know, it's a wonderful tool for those vegetables.
Now, can you buy a mandolin just about any
anywhere,
cooking supply store?
Anywhere. Okay. Yep. Any of your local big box stores, too. So great job.
Oh, no, okay. Is that enough?
That's enough.
Okay.
Great. I just wanted to give everybody
an idea
that if you wanted to use fresh potatoes, you'd actually lower the sodium to zero from the potatoes because there's zero milligrams of sodium in the potato.
Where did the name mandolin, is it because it looks like a prep?
Yeah, I don't know why that is the name of that tool, but that's what we're in extension for. I can go look that up and get back to you.
Well, I appreciate it.
So I will do that. Thank you so much.
Yeah, great.
That looks
great. Thank you for the instructions and how to use it.
Sure. All right. So our beans are probably already ready.
Okay, so
we did enough time with that.
The potatoes have been warmed.
Right. And I'm going to turn that on and come on back. Now, see how they're just kind of smelling great. They look a little, little like darker, you know, in the green color. So it pulls out that green color. So the next ingredient before I put those hot beans in with the chicken is your choice.
Okay.
Would you like the cream of chicken soup
cream of chicken,
or
mushroom.
A cream of mushroom
soup? Oh, let's
soup.
Go with mushrooms.
Okay, we'll give it a different try today. So what you want to do is open that can up, and then we're going to be real frugal and try to get all of that condensed soup out of the can. Great job.
Let me put this out of the
way
and get it all right in with the
and
tuna.
I gave you that so that you can
put it. So we separated, right?
Yeah.
And then
you can just keep that. You can just keep that there because we'll end up using that. So
and you want to get it much out, get it all out if I can.
And then remember too that another way to lower the sodium, lower the fat is I went through the store carefully looking at all my labels and chose one that was fat-free and a lower reduced sodium. condensed soup.
An educated cooker is a better cooker.
Well, and just keep looking at those labels. Yeah, that's what we teach a lot of. So a lot of times they say when people, dietitians teach that, it does take a little more time to go through and do your shopping, but it's really worth it in the end.
It's worth it health-wise.
It is.
How are we looking?
Very good.
Okay.
So now what we're going to do, these beans, because they're in a strainer, have, you know, really kind of strained through, right, and the water's come off of there. So I'm just going to take that next. All right. And they just go in.
Let me smush them up.
That's all you got to do.
Okay.
Yep. And I'll pull these off.
Mmm. Smells good and looks good.
Easy, isn't it?
Oh, this is easy.
Four ingredients.
So far, we're batting 1,000.
All right.
Oh, yeah. Looks very good. And nothing has been difficult so far, right?
Nothing. Easy opening the cans. That's right. But you sang. You sang for us, and that was good.
You're being kind by calling that singing. Thank you very much. Great. Okay, how we look?
Very nice.
How can I put that? Where'd you like it?
Okay, now what you're going to do is just prepare. You can put that, keep that in there, because you're still going to need that.
Okay.
We're going to prepare our pan by just spraying a little bit of this spray
all
into
the way around.
Just a little bit, just to make sure that we get some in there. Yeah, and it doesn't take much because we do have a lot with this.
All right, does that look good?
That looks great. Then what you want to do is, using that lip, you're going to take and scrape that and put it right down in, flatten that out.
My home economics teacher in seventh grade is smiling up in heaven.
Oh, great. Well, in the meantime, I'm bringing over those tater tots that we got, right?
Yes, we're getting all types of very nice aromas there. When TV gets to the point where you can have smell of vision, then I know we've done something right.
Okay. Very good.
Want me to spread these out?
Spread that out a little bit in the pan. Oh, you're doing a fantastic job.
Okay.
Yeah.
How's that?
That's perfect.
Okay.
Okay. Now I will take the tater tot. Puffs just kind of
that's onto the top. Be careful, folks.
They're a little hot. So we're just going to take and lay those over.
Mmm, looks terrific.
And it looks really great in the end. It's just a tasty dish. And as I say, you can make those variations. You chose the cream of mushroom.
Oh, yes.
And I have another one to show you that has cream of chicken.
Okay. So.
And has the
it smells
French cut
good.
Greens.
I know it's going to taste good, but it looks good.
Okay,
right? It looks very
That's
good.
All you need to do. We're going to put that in the oven for 350 degree oven, and that goes in only about 20 minutes.
Is that all right?
Okay, make sure I put that up. Great. Okay.
And that took no time.
No time at all.
And no effort.
No time. So we shall talk a little bit more about swaps. Okay. Because it is National Fast Food Day, I also wanted to make sure that, we covered some areas of concern and issues with people saying, well, I might not be able to find the healthiest fast foods, but there's quite a few of them.
Yes.
Okay.
You just got to look, right?
You've got to look, and you got to know a few little little tips. So we can start even in the morning with coffee.
Okay.
If you are to swap out the sugar for cinnamon and a little bit of vanilla flavoring.
It'll give it a sweet taste and a flavor, right?
That's right, because it kind of fools the taste buds.
Yes.
So
get rid of the sugar,
which
we know is going to cause problems, and put cinnamon.
And you can try maybe an almond or plant-based beverage, too, to swap out some of the calories for the milk.
My son has got me in the oat milk and almond milk and stuff like that, so you've taught him well.
Okay. There's many types, but so that's the coffee. Okay. How about an egg in the morning? Do you eat eggs or not?
I love eggs in the morning, but I cheat. I get as many scrambled eggs as I can. You don't want to know what I put on it, ketchup and everything I can. What should I do?
Well, on one of the days, try just swapping out that whole egg for egg whites, two of them, and a quarter cup of the egg substitute.
Okay, you can the egg, just get rid of the rest of the egg and eat the egg white.
Right,
okay.
Try that. And that's one swap.
Sure.
Okay. How about if you use any yogurts?
I put honey and wheat germ, and my yogurt starts at this size and it goes to that. So what should I be doing?
Well, first is what you talked about, portion control.
Right.
So about 6 to 8 ounces is a great amount. And you can swap out and use Greek yogurt instead of
which is very popular
plain yogurt.
Acme or wherever you shop, it's full of Greek yogurt.
Right. It offers a little extra protein too, because the way that they strain that off, they have to actually use more milk And so that is how you have more protein in the Greek. It's a little more concentrated.
So you're better off with a Greek yogurt. I did not know that.
If you like that taste and that texture. Sometimes people don't like that texture as much.
So. I love Greek yogurt. It's terrific.
Okay, great. That's another swap. Okay. Then you could swap, you know, sour cream or dips. You can use it that way. So
I love yogurt.
All right. How about herbs? I have been teaching so much about herbs and spices.
Well, everything I read, they're healthy for you in so many ways. So what should we do?
Lower in sodium, and they have a lot of antioxidants. And in using that, instead of adding on the salt, okay, you see, I didn't really add any salt today.
No, you didn't?
You can finish this product a little bit with a little bit of salt. You know, you can add a little salt.
Just a pinch, a pinch.
Right, a little pinch, like when we were making the green beans. You can do that, but I really wanted to keep it lower sodium for everybody.
And the herbs you can buy, I mean, where I shop.
Right.
They have them. When I was growing up, they didn't. Now you go any grocery store, and guess what? There's a whole
section.
Put
it on your windowsills and grow some more at home, then you have it to go. But if that's a healthy swap, because Americans really shouldn't be eating more than about 2,300 milligrams of sodium.
It's killing us all.
Yeah, well, people are eating more because, you know, they are eating more than the 2,300 milligrams. So. How about Chinese? Do you like to eat
Chinese? I love Chinese. Okay. Centerville has a wonderful Chinese place.
Oh, that's great. All right. And Chinese, you can look and see, do they have, you know, different lower sodium options?
I should ask for them when I actually go buy it, when I get the order. Okay.
Right? You can ask for tofu, steamed tofu, instead of some of the other options.
Oh, nice.
You can add in and load up on the vegetables. And ask if they have possibly a brown rice instead of white rice or fried rice.
And most of the Chinese restaurants I go do, right?
Right.
They have the brown rice.
They have the brown rice. That's really helpful.
Am I all right with those? Or should I back off?
You know how that's a small size? You can have that as a treat. Why
rather than two large.
Portion control. So.
Okay.
Great. Lettuce wraps. Those are another option.
Rather than bread or just wrapping.
Right.
And now I see, again, where I shop, lettuce wraps have a whole section. Because obviously they're becoming more popular.
They are. And it's an easy way to just lose some of that carbohydrate.
And it's healthier for you.
Right.
Why not?
If you don't like soy sauce, if it's possibly something that you're allergic to, there's other options. Like you can at home have some aminos that can help and replace
that. Is soy sauce okay?
It is okay.
I love soy sauce.
Some people do have allergies to soy.
Okay.
But those are not as common
as
we would think.
Find something else.
Right.
Okay.
So that's another option. How about pizza?
Killing me. Saturday night, make it thick, put everything on top of it.
Here's what I got
to
tell you.
Tell me
because
what to do.
One of our seniors even talked about that at one of our programs. He said that he makes a thin crust pizza
with
a tortilla. You know, he uses it that way.
Okay.
It saves on the carbohydrates. And then you can buy different alternative cheeses.
Right.
You know, if you do that, sometimes that'll help or a low part skim moisture mozzarella.
So should I get the thin pizza with just tomato sauce and a little bit of cheese?
How about veggies? Add up the veggies.
The veggie pizzas are all right.
Sure,
they actually have veggie pizzas.
Yeah, try artichokes and spinach and different, you know.
So like anything we eat, as many vegetables as I can put on my pizza is a good thing too.
Right, pizza can be fine. Just load that up too, add some extra veggies. You can order shredded chicken instead of the pepperoni
bacon or whatever
and all that stuff, sausage.
Right.
So, do you ever try Indian cuisine?
My wife likes it, but yes, it's sometimes a little too spicy for me, but excellent.
Excellent. A lot of their spices that they use will blend well with all different types of meats, so that's why that's a great choice. And also, they use a lot of lentils, kidney beans, black beans.
Good healthy stuff.
Right. Yes. It's good for your heart, and it's also good for bone health. It has a lot of calcium in it, so it's good for dental and bone
health. I was talking to a woman
health.
At church today. That's the biggest problem she has. A lot of women, calcium becomes a major factor in their life as they grow older.
Right.
The bones break, and the bones don't work as they used to.
And it's so good to keep eating and having those 3 cups of some type of dairy each day. So very good. Okay, how about, I'm thinking Mexican.
Oh,
like
Mexican, my wife and I love.
Oh, you like a great variety of foods, Fred. Oh. That's great.
Unfortunately, I do like a great variety
of foods. Because we're going through all the healthy options now, right?
I'm glad I know these now.
Try to opt and take out like the fried bowl for the salad and opt for, again, less sour cream, more vegetables. And fajitas, they're still a great protein choice.
Okay.
But
with the beans and stuff like that.
Right, you just want to make sure you add more vegetables than
how about
some
the guacamole
others.
And avocado? Am I all right with those?
You're okay with those because avocados are a great healthy fat.
Vitamin E,
providing omega-3 and
a
vitamin E. The thing is you want to choose, instead of using the fried chips to dip in them, pull some vegetables.
Oh, you're making it tough on me.
That's
harder,
but
you're teaching me the right thing.
Okay.
Football game's coming up on Sunday, there's fried chips. But so what's the guacamole what would I put it on if not chips and
oh,
stuff?
Oh, you can try a crunchy carrot, a little
okay.
celery.
Oh, so put fruit,
yeah,
vegetables.
Yeah, radish,
okay.
if, you know, anything that you'd okay. like to try, something
like
different,
that.
A lot of color too.
Good idea.
So, and if you're on the road, because I know I'm on the road a lot, mm-hmm. Healthy snacks are available, right?
Okay.
There's different cheese sticks, there's the Greek yogurt we talked about, there's hummus that you can also dip.
Well, I like the,
you know,
I like the convenience stores now. All of a sudden, they were white bread and they were sugar and there was salt. Now there's a whole section
right.
of healthy eating stuff in most
it's
convenience
great.
Stores you go to. It is good.
Even proteins like
yes.
Hard cooked eggs or mm-hmm. looking for healthy bars. They now made with nuts and fruits, and you can look and see some of the nut mixtures have shown this because these are pepitas.
Pepitas.
They are a raw, unshelled. There's no shell. Pumpkin seed.
Okay.
And these are really heart healthy. I don't know.
Pumpkin like Halloween pumpkin.
Yeah.
Okay.
Although this is with no shells. That's why they have
no
the
shells.
Green color.
Okay.
So they're raw. Delicious. So maybe
and you can, and
you can try
and
some of those.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. We'll do oh,
that.
Yes.
That's great. They are wonderful.
They're
they
better than my salted cashews, I have a feeling. Yes.
They use some of those every day. Grind them up. Put them into smoothies.
Okay.
You can use them in so many ways on salads.
Can you just take a handful and chew
sure,
them?
Sure. Okay. They taste great. They taste great. And then you'll see a lot more of those in those nut mixes that are out there on the road. So, okay. So really, we just wanted to show that whether you want to choose, you know, this recipe that we have with the four simple ingredients.
Which was simple.
Wasn't it? We're going to wait and see our end product here. But whether you choose that, the potato puff casserole, or whether you wanted to choose some healthy swaps when
yeah,
dining out.
I really
out,
appreciate your swaps.
You know, those are really helpful. And I do want to, you know, remind everybody that you go to the link for the sheet that we have, the fact sheet. It's full of great information. We made this as a companion piece for our Dining with Diabetes programming. And so we thought that with that, this would also help to show everyone more about
okay.
these healthy swaps.
Oh, great, so, the swaps are easy, and they're
great.
All easy. They're easy.
Great.
Which is good.
And my contact information is going to also come up on the screen, but shall we show our end
the
results?
Finished product? Oh, I can't.
Finished product?
I can't wait
okay.
to see. And I made this?
You made this.
Oh, come on.
You
man,
made
we're
it.
Looking good.
Great. Grab that.
Smells delicious. Looks delicious.
Oh, that looks
and we did this
wonderful.
In what, 10 minutes, 5 minutes? How
yeah,
long
that was a really quick recipe. That's yours.
Terrific.
All right, and then I wanted to show another option
okay.
I had created with the tuna, and this is the one that has the French cut green bean, okay? And potato
a little
puffs.
More decorative in some
well,
ways,
the
yes.
reason why I did that, showed you the how to do the mandolin, and you did it so
yes,
expertly,
yes.
is to show you how nice those come
oh, really
out.
Perfect.
Low sodium, real low sodium
this
on that
side. It's a dangerous
side.
Spot. You don't know this delicious aroma coming. This is tough. I want overtime for this. I'm going to contact the union on this one.
All right. Let's see. We have another version here,
be
too.
Careful.
I know. I'll be extra careful. Good thing that these are nice and
oh,
big.
Oh, they're nice and big. Now.
Yeah. So just another option, and the way that that
delicious.
Looks when it comes out hot.
The camera
just
crews
beautiful.
Abandoned the cameras. They're charging.
You're
gonna
come on over huh, and eat. So, but we hope that for all of those that are doing the caregiving, you know, for their ones that they love, that they'll find something like this that will be easy and a nice healthy swap. And I'm really glad that I could join you again this year.
Well, Cheryl, thank you very much. You've done an excellent job. The swaps. Hey, next time I order pizza, it's gonna be, I'm going to get thin crust,
there you go.
And I'm going to do it the right way.
You're starting
right?
there because you changed your tune from
you
that big, thick crust. So.
And thank you. You're one of the few women in the world that will allow me in a kitchen. So thank
oh.
you very much.
Our senior center employee is going to show us how to make snowflakes.
So the first snowflake that I want to make today is called snowflake number one. So we will need 6 of these 6x6 square papers. We're going to fold them in half once. Then you're going to fold them in half again. So what we have is a double folded end and a single fold or spine end. So we're going to take our scissors. And we're going to cut from the double fold toward the top spine. I'm going to make 3 cuts. Of course, I don't want to go all the way to the spine. I need to leave space to keep them connected. First cut, this is our second cut. We'll unfold this. This is so simple. You remember making these as a kid. I'll need tape. So we will pull the inside little triangles together. And tape it. I'm going to flip it over. Pull the next two triangles together, the middle section. Just press them together and tape it. Our cardstock paper here is a little bit stiff. So with this, I'm going to go inside and tape again. I don't want them to pop apart. We would do the same. We flip it over and do it again with the outside square. Again, we're just pulling them together in the middle and taping them. For extra strength, I'm going to tape it from the inside. So this is one of six sections that we'll have to make snowflake number one. Again, I have a square. It's a double-sided pattern. I'm going to fold it in half to make one triangle. And then I'm going to fold it again to make a smaller triangle. Kind of thick, nice heavy cardstock. So I have the double folded edge and the single spine edge. And these are four individual pages that ends that we're going to leave alone. So we're going to cut from the double edge up to the spine edge, but we can't cut through it. So we're going just like this. I need three cuts. This is one. Okay, makes sense? Unfold it. So now we're going to take this inner square, make a little loop, tape it. Flip it over. Take the middle section, put them together. We don't want our snowflakes falling apart. So I'm going to tape it from the inside also. Then you flip that over again. Take the outer edges. Tape them together. That's all it is to it, to making the little squares. So we actually have six of these. We are paying attention to the direction because we have double-sided prints. We want all our prints to go in the same direction. So this is mittens and leaves. Mittens, leaves, mittens, leaves. So this would kind of be messy. Okay, so I'm gonna pick them up, one, two, tape. Did it twice and it still didn't stick. We fixed him. Okay, one, two, and three sections together. This we don't want to tape, we have to staple this. Do you see half a snowflake here? Same thing with the next three. I'm going to make sure they're going in the same direction. Gather them. One, two, three. Staple it. So now you have the two sections, and the tricky part is to staple these two sections together. And we're doing it right. We have to also pay attention to the each side paddle, because we still want them all going in the same direction. So this is where we maybe should have a really thin craft kind of stapler to fit up in there, but we can get them. So this is their finished snowflake. The ends don't quite align up, so we're going to staple them as well, just to hold them in place. Just going all the way around. Putting our little edges together so that they don't get too sloppy. So this is our finished snowflake. If we feel happy, we can hole punch a hole in him and tie a fishing line, a string, a ribbon, whatever you like, and hang him from the ceiling. This is what I plan to do to decorate. So we do have one over here all finished and hanging. So this is our snowflake number one, right? The second snowflake that we want to make, really, if he were green, it would look a lot like a Christmas tree. I don't know his proper name, but I call him snowflake number two. So again, we're going to need six sections. I brought four already finished just to speed things up. I'm starting again with the 6x6 pattern paper. This is cardstock. Purchased it online. You can get it at craft supplies houses. Fold them in half only. So, that other snowflake, we folded it again, but this one we don't. So I've made a little template because we have to mark lines on it. 3, 4, 5, 6. We need 6 little marks. I want to make sure that all 6 parts of the snowflake are even, so I made a template just to keep that spaced correctly. And then when I cut these, I'm just going to cut them going right straight up, but I can't hit the spine, so everyone sees which end to cut. Holding it like this, this is along the bottom end. And I'm going right to the top, but I can't overdo it. Four. So we have 6 little parts. If I open it up, it might resemble a leaf. You see all the different sections. So we definitely tape on these as well. So with this one, just paying attention to how this was done, and we're going to take the top little section and kind of pull them together. Maybe you think of a cone. So it looks like that. This end's a little small, so you might take a pen or pencil or even your scissor tips to close up, to press on the tape that's inside. And then we're gonna flip it over. and do the same thing in this direction. So when I tape these, I like to make the tape a little bit longer. Tape it across the seam, press the edges under, flip it over. Do it again, tape it right across the seam. Tuck those edges underneath, that helps tape it on both sides. Are you seeing the little Christmas tree? Okay, take the next two sections. Tape, this is so easy. Flipping it. And then we got the last one. Flip it over. So we're alternating patterns. So there's my one little Christmas tree. Looks like I cut it pretty close right there. So I'm gonna stick a piece of tape there before he ends up falling off. Okay, so there's one section, and again, we'll do one more. So we have the 6x6 square. We just folded it in half to be a triangle. Turned it, so my spine side is the one I'm not gonna cut through. I'm gonna make little cuts from the bottom. So I would mark each one, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This ensures that they're consistently the same size strips. And we're going to start on this end. Okay, all the way up to the spine, but not through it. Two. Okay, we've got our strips cut. We're gonna open it up. Again, it looks like a leaf. We're gonna use tape. We're gonna tape that first section. This is the tightest one, the smallest. Put that tape on there, and I just kind of press it inside because I can't really reach it. Flip it over. The next two sections you'll gather. Strip the tape right across the gathering and I push them inside. And flip and tape another one. So maybe we can have lots of snowflakes in the house instead of too harsh of a winter. Okay, last one on this section. Taping, tucking it under. So there's my sixth little section. Okay, just like first snowflake number one, snowflake number two has, we wanna make sure that our prints are going in the same direction. We're gonna put three sections together and staple them. Snowflake. And do the same thing with the other three sections that we made. we're going to put the two sections together, and we have to make sure that we're running in the same direction. Okay, with this snowflake, we don't even attach one section to the other. They just kind of meld together there. We would hole punch a hole in it, tie a string, and hang it up. So this is our sample of snowflake number two. Don't we love it? Got one more to show you. Let's find the goodies to make him. This is our snowflake number three. He requires a template. It was just easier for me to make it than to remember every time how to cut it. The snowflake looks like this guy. If we were really energetic, we could put two together to have them dimensional. Okay, and part of me feels like, you know what? This is pretty groovy like it is. We put a little sticker on the back. So the back is more plain, but when you add something on it that kind of coordinates with it, it's all good. So this is our finished snowflake. This one's finished. The beauty of this snowflake, it's just one square. We're going to, now this one I had started so I could remember it. So we're starting with one square and we're going to fold it in half. And then we're going to fold it again in half to make a smaller triangle. So, and then we have our little template. So basically, we have the spine end, we have the double-sided end, and then we have the four loose ones in the bottom. That's at the bottom. Okay, so we're going to take our little template, hold it on our triangle, and I want to mark it to know where to cut it. Again, so they're pretty consistent in the size. Okay, so I just put two lines, and I need to cut out this section in the middle. We're going to cut it out and get rid of that, we don't need it. So this gives our snow shape not a square shape. Okay, we're getting rid of those little sections. So this is what we have. I'm going to follow my lines that I drew on there. See the little sections that we've got? Okay, so then we want to know, do we, now we have two sides to this snowflake. Depending on, this snowflake has a dark reverse and a light front side. same with these. So depending on how you want the bigger parts to be, for this, we're gonna do one of each. So we're gonna put the light side up. We're going to pull this one section in and tape it down. You may like to use those little adhesive dots that crafters use. Do the same thing with the second one. Oh no, I did not do that right. Come on guys, start again. We're gonna start with the light side up. We're gonna take the middle section. And tape it down. So this leaves the inside and the outside sections. We're gonna do it to all four. Middle sections, tape them. There's one and two. And for the fourth one, So in the name of security, I'm going to staple them all together. Keep them down. So this is the finished little baby snowflake. Again, if you wanted to do two and put them back to back, you would alternate how they go together. And you'll have the three-dimensional aspect on both sides. Going back to this guy. For this one, we're gonna put the dark side up. We're gonna grab, it's one, two, three little sections here, and we're grabbing the middle one. And we will tape it down. Across from him, I'm grabbing the next middle section. Last one on this guy. To make it good and secure, I am stapling it. So there it is. Again, you could do a hole punch and a string and let him hang and dangle. Another thought would be to put the plastic sequins that you could buy. These are not very glitzy or reflective. But if you put little sequins on them, they might reflect the light as they spin around. So there are my three happy snowflakes.
Next, we're gonna see chair exercises. And that's presented by the members of the Graysonville Senior Center.
No matter what age we are, exercising is very important, especially for those of us who may be over the age of 65. Whether we enjoy it or not, exercising on a regular basis continues to keep our body moving and functioning properly as we age. Without getting up and entertaining our muscles with movement, we reduce the chances of aging healthfully. As a caregiver, your loved one might love or hate exercising, but they've been continuing to be told exercising is healthy for you. What if now they're experiencing a mobility block? In younger years, they might have been able to run 10 miles a day or compete in a triathlon. Now, it's just getting harder to even stand. Chair exercises are a great substitute for aging adults. There doesn't need to be a weight set, a trainer, and seniors don't even have to have a caregiver with them at all times. The only thing a senior needs is a chair. Some of the following exercises may require a resistance band or dumbbells to perform accurately with the results. Keep in mind, everyone has different levels of comfort when it comes to exercise. For safety, it's important to start slow. Develop a health program that is tailored to your abilities. Exercising on a regular basis, preferably at least 30 minutes per day, will not only keep an aging adult's heart healthy, but can also prevent strokes, heart attacks, falling, high blood pressure, and chronic diseases such as dementia. Not everyone over the age of 65 is able to move agilely or even out of their seat, but this shouldn't mean that they can't exercise. So many regular exercises can be done while using a chair as a mobility device. Before getting started on any of the exercises, consult a doctor if you recently went through surgery, have had recent injuries that could be agitated by using a particular muscle or set of muscles, or if you can't physically perform the perfect posture during any of the exercises. Even the slightest difference to the correct form of each exercise could result in pain or further injury. One easy exercise is your biceps. Grab a pair of dumbbells or resistance band. Using the band, slide it under your foot or the chair and have it at equal length on both sides of the body. Sit comfortably in the chair with your hips as far back as possible to ensure that your back is firm to the backrest of the chair. Keep your core tight, and while keeping tension, slightly lower your forearms back and forth from the starting position, lifting the band comfortably. The seated bicep curl is an easy exercise. Do 2 to 3 sets with 8 to 12 reps, and the timing should be about 4 minutes. Knee extensions are another easy exercise that are great to ensure better mobility. Sit comfortably in the chair with hips as far back as possible, ensure that the back is firm to the backrest of the chair. Keep your core tight once again. Place both hands at the side of the chair and grip the seat to keep stable. Keep both legs at a 90 degree angle with the chair. Extend one leg in front of your body up in the air until a full extension is made. Keep the other in its original position for stability. Slowly draw the one leg back to the starting position and repeat on both legs to count as one set. You should do 2 to 3 sets, 8 to 12 reps, in about 6 minutes. Next, we can do the side stretch. You can do this by standing directly in front of your chair or by sitting comfortably at the edge of your chair. Secure the core by keeping the back upright and spine straight, keeping both feet flat on the floor, keeping the hips and lower body in a stable position. If you're sitting, use your right hand, grab the right side of the seat to stabilize yourself. Extend your left hand above the head, making a similar shape to that of a spoon or a lengthened C. Simultaneously, slowly shift the upper torso to the right side without collapsing your abdomen. Remember to keep it tight and hold that position. Repeat 3 to 5 times, or as comfortable as you can, per side. And finish your stretching after 3 to 5 sets. Front shoulder raises. Grab a pair of dumbbells or your resistance band or even a medicine ball. You can also do this while sitting comfortably in the chair with your hips as far back as possible. Keep your core tight and your chest out. With the dumbbells, keep your arms to the sides of the body. Let them hang naturally with both palms facing towards your body. Keeping the arms straight and their palms in their facing positions, continue to move the arms up in front of the body, raising the dumbbells till they reach your chest. Proceed to slowly return to the starting position while doing 2 to 3 sets of 8 to 12 reps. Next is the chair squat. Sit comfortably in the chair toward the edge of the seat. Keep the core tight. Stick the chest out. Ensure the toes are pointed toward or slightly outward to both sides. Keep both hands in front of the body in a comfortable position for balance. Slowly sit up in the chair until fully standing. Check the knee placement when moving from sitting to standing so they aren't bending inward. Instead, they should be projecting outward from the middle of the body. Sit back down while checking for that knee placement to starting position. Do 2 to 3 sets for 8 to 12 reps in about 5 minutes. These are just a couple of exercises that you can do with a chair to help extend your mobility and be healthier. In conclusion, older adults should never overexert themselves while doing any of the previous movements. This could lead to injury or worse. If their body is resisting any of the movements suggested, they shouldn't push their body any further. Our bodies talk to us when we exercise. They tell us when something is good, or they tell us when something is bad. As always, when a senior is performing any of the chair exercises, they should consider what their body is saying. It's okay to ask for help or to take things slow when performing any of the exercises we've shown you today.
We thank you for joining us. And remember, always call the MAP line first. 410-758-1040. And we're located in the Queen Anne's County Area Agency on Aging's building, 104 Pyle Street, Centerville, Maryland. Have a good day, everyone. And remember, you are the spice in our lives.